The seventh generation of Pokemon games introduced us to the Alola region, and this region in many ways was a big departure for the normal structure of the series. There were no gyms to battle, there wasn't even a true champion, and we even saw the introduction of interdimensional Pokemon with the Ultra Beasts. A lot of strange things happened in this generation for sure, and today we are going to highlight some of the stranger secrets and Easter eggs that came out of this generation. You know what's not strange though? Just how good the sponsor of today's video is, Ridge Wallet. Ridge Wallet is a wallet that redefines just how good a wallet can be, all while leaving your traditional everyday wallets in the dust. Not only can it hold up to 12 cards plus cash, it does so while still being significantly smaller than your average wallet. It fits in your pocket so much better, and personally, I would never go back to a regular wallet after using this thing. It is just that good. Additionally, the Ridge Wallet also has 30,000 five-star reviews, comes in over 30 colors and styles, has RFID blocking technology built in to keep your credit card information safe, has a lifetime warranty, and even comes with a 45-day money-back guarantee. They're even offering 10% off with free worldwide shipping and returns by going to ridge.com/hoops and entering code HOOPS at checkout. Link for that will be in the description. I've been using the Ridge Wallet for a while now, and I can absolutely recommend it to everyone who is still carrying around your typical bifold or trifold. Thank you so much to Ridge for sponsoring the channel. Their support really does help to bring videos like this to all of you guys, so be sure to check them out and show them some love with the link in the description. Alright, starting things off is a strange occurrence that seemed like it was going to relate to the plot of the Alola games, but never amounted to anything. When the Ultra Beasts were first being revealed, many people noticed how several of them looked exactly like various human characters in the game, such as Lily resembling Nihilego, Lusamine resembling Faramosa, and Guzma resembling Zerkatry. The physical similarities for all these characters is frankly uncanny, and is assuredly too on the nose to be just a coincidence, so it seemed at the time that this would be factoring into the story of Sun and Moon, but the thing is, it really didn't at all. While Lily's resemblance to Nihilego is explained as her mother being so obsessed with the Pokemon that she wanted to dress her daughter up to look like one, the other two scenarios involving Zerkatry and Faramosa are not explained at all. It's very odd to see something that so very likely has more to it than meets the eye, though not explored or touched on hardly at all. I certainly think there's more to this story that we don't know, but who knows if we'll ever find out the answer. Getting into some Easter eggs, there are actually a couple of very direct Mario Easter eggs in the Alola games. In one of the boutiques throughout the region, if you take a look around, you'll see an outfit hanging on the wall that is none other than the iconic red shirt and overalls of our favorite Italian plumber. That's not where the Mario referencing ends though, as just outside your house on Route 1, there is a youngster with a Rockruff that, when talked to, will exclaim that, "Holding B will make me a B Dasher." While this is in context to teaching the player how to run in the game, it's also a reference to Mario Kart, where a kart named the B Dasher appears in a number of different Mario Kart titles. In Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon on the outer cape of Molly City, there is a rising star named Ninoa, who can not only be battled, but also upon talking to him, mentions a person named Arabella. This is actually in reference to a gym trainer named Arabella, who resides in the Viridian Gym in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. Characters referencing other characters is certainly nothing new to the Pokemon series, but a reference to a random gym trainer, of which there are hundreds by now in the series, is definitely a reference out of left field. Speaking of NPC trainers being used to make references, there are a couple in the Alola games who make some interesting ones. At the Haoli Cemetery, there is a Pokemon breeder named Akue who uses a Pikachu. This is a reference to Akue Ohtani, the voice actress of Pikachu itself. On a more somber note, however, there are also some twins on Route 5 in Alola named Issa and Nico, who are named after the daughters of a man named Eric Medall. Medall was the creative design director for the Pokemon Company, who unfortunately in 2016 passed away when a tree collapsed onto his car following a harsh windstorm. As the creative design director, Medall was responsible for many graphical elements seen in the TCG games and anime. There is a location in the Alola region that basically only serves two purposes, and one of them is to be a reference, and an ironic one at that. The Fossil Restoration Center, located on Route 8, does as its name implies and is able to restore any fossils you might find throughout your adventure. If you talk to the man who runs it, however, he will say that his dream is to make a park full of restored fossils and, quote, bring the ancient world back to life. While this never comes to fruition in the games, it's a very clear reference to Jurassic Park, a reference which is made since the movie was filmed in Hawaii where the Alola region is based. What's ironic about this, however, is that Hawaii is relatively young, and as such does not have any fossils of its own, which is also why the Alola region didn't introduce any new fossil Pokemon. A very cool detail in Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon that can pretty easily be overlooked is that Pokemon like Cubone, Pikachu, and Exeggute, whose evolutions have Alola forms, will actually evolve into their Kantonian form evolutions if evolved anywhere in Ultra Space. This is naturally because in Ultra Space, you are no longer in the Alola region, so it only makes sense for those Pokemon to evolve into their standard forms here, and it was a very nice attention to detail for Game Freak to include. Meanwhile, also in Ultra Space, the theme music for the Ultra Space Wilds, which is essentially the travel hub area for the various worlds of Ultra Space, is actually a reversed arrangement of the main Alola region theme. Additionally, the theme music of Guzzlord's world, the Ultra Ruin, is also a reversed arrangement of Howoli City's theme. From the Ultra Space Wilds to the Pony Wilds, there's an NPC in this location who, when talked to, will say, "We're going on a berry hunt, we're going to find a big one." This is a reference to, of all things, the children's book We're Going on a Bear Hunt, written by Michael Rosen. Given that the book was published in 1989, it's possible that this reference was put in by a localizer who was fond of the book as a child. Lastly, we're going to end the video the way we started it with another very obscure observation about Pokemon Sun and Moon's development. It's long been known that Pokemon games typically take 3 years of development time, and begin development right after the most recent game is finished. This is a schedule that has been in place basically since the series started, but there is evidence to suggest that Pokemon Sun and Moon in particular had an unusually long development cycle. There are a couple of various obvious hints in Pokemon X and Y to Sun and Moon, most notably the strange souvenir. Knowing what we know now, this is clearly a reference to the Alola region, and more specifically, the Island Guardians, but what it shows is that when this hint was put in the game, which would have been months at least prior to X and Y's release, Game Freak already knew that the next region in the series was going to be based on Hawaii, and they already had the idea in place for the Island Guardian legendaries. Furthermore, in Anastar City, there is a huge hint to the Gen 7 games as the city is home to a giant sundial, and an NPC mentions that there are also moon dials that exist as well. This clearly hints at the title of the games, which again would have had to have been finalized at least months ahead of X and Y's release for them to include this in the game, which again is extremely unusual for Pokemon. Typically, based on what we've learned through various interviews, around the time a new generation begins is when Game Freak just barely starts to look at the next one and begins deciding very basic things like what place the next region will be based on, and so on. So to not only have that set in stone, but also the concepts of several legendary Pokemon, and even the names of the games themselves, months seemingly at least ahead of the release of the first Gen 6 games, suggests that Sun and Moon were being developed for a significantly longer amount of time than is typical for the debut title of any Pokemon generation. This actually falls in line with a theory I have mentioned before, that Sun and Moon were given extra development time because they were going to be celebrating the 20th anniversary of the franchise, which in turn is also possibly why we did not get a third Kalos game, because resources were focused on making Sun and Moon as good as they could be for the 20th anniversary. With seemingly such a long development time, it makes you wonder what all was considered for these titles throughout the process of making them, and how they ended up progressing over the course of development. Thank you all so much for watching my video. Be sure to like if you enjoyed, and subscribe if you haven't already for more Pokemon content. Big thank you again to RidgeWallet for supporting the channel. Be sure to check them out with the link in the description, and if you would like to further support the channel, consider checking out my Pokemon remixes on Spotify, and watching my Pokemon Cardinal project, the first two episodes of which are out right now. Any and all support on those things is very much appreciated, and I will be back Thursday with another video. So until then, as always, I love you all, and I will smell you guys later.